are transmitted. Depending upon their signal strength and everything, the signal to noise ratio is changed. Therefore, the last arriving packet signal to noise ratio is increased by 10 if the receiver is not able to decode it properly. So it will be transmitted. But in MIM incapable networks, the signal to noise ratio is same throughout. So if the receiver is placed at some different positions, the signal will be not be decoded. This is the property of MIM. And with MIM, the concurrency is increased. Slide number 9 for that graph. First arriving and last arriving delivery ratios. For optimum analysis, it was found that MIM scheduling was NP-hard, and since it is not of that use. Slide number 11, you can see that MIM capable receivers and MIM incapable receivers difference. The difference is, both in MIM capable, first arriving and last arriving packets are received, and signal to noise ratio first is low in MIM capable, and last requirement is of 10 dB. That is, it is increased. With MIM incapable, the signal to noise requirement is uniformly 4 dB. So last arriving packet cannot be received. Now the graph after that is about the concurrency, which is received link concurrency. So it is just like with MIM, the link concurrency is increased. Now the problem with MIM capable was that the appropriate ordering used to happen by chance. Like controller used to just assume that okay, the links are in order, and then now I will be transmitting particular manner. And so if the link conflicts used to occur, the AP again used to inform the controller. But in MIM aware, we force the links to be links are transmitting in order. We force in checkout the links are transmitting in proper order, and this is done using a shuffle system. Shuffle working is important, I think. So in this paper, if sir will be giving anything, will be shuffle. It is a MIM aware link layer solution. It reorder transmissions for improving concurrency and tested on small scales. The operations are conflict diagnosis, packet scheduling and schedule execution. Coming to the slide number 16. In this diagram, the controller, the packet waiting notification diagram, you can see. In that, basically when the packet arrives at AP's end, it notifies the controller and adds the packet in the queue. After that, the controller controller decide which link should be activated so that the packets are transmitted in particular order and using the link scheduler. And then it notifies AP. AP after getting notification transferred back in the network. And this transmission is continued till the controller schedules an upload window. In upload window, it gets the acknowledgement. The client sends the acknowledgement to AP, and through the acknowledgement, AP get to know that what all signals are being failed to be received by the receiver. Okay.
5 minutes.
Failed to be received by the receiver. Then again notifies the controller reschedules, and then again AP retransmit using some different links. That's it, I think so. Okay. Then at slide number 18, it is MIM aware scheduling is again NP hard and conflicts are asymmetric. So to overcome this problem, greedy heuristic is used. And in greedy heuristic, actually in greedy heuristic what happens is, like controller sees, want to check which packet should be transmitted properly, which packet is having conflicts. So for say if packet controller wants to check packet for P1, the conflicts. So it will compare this packet with all other packets in the queue, and say if it gets that P1 is concurrent with P2, so the conflict score will remain unchanged. And if P1 is transmitted earlier, then the conflict will come. Therefore, the conflict controller will change the conflict score to +1. So this is how it determines the conflict score of all the packets, and based on that conflict score, it sets it in an increasing order,